Hello, in this episode of Bounty Vlog, I will tell you how I almost threw away $4,000 worth of bugs, but instead I doubled my earnings of 100-hour challenge of bug hunting on Stripe. And doing this, I got to the top 2 on the leaderboard on Hackerone. Make sure to stick until the end because I also have a small challenge for you. But for now, enjoy. For a long time, I was learning about bug bounty much more than I was actually doing it. I was hearing a lot of tips like, you just have to persist. You can literally go to example.com and start hunting there, and there are bugs everywhere. And as a pentester, I thought that bug bounty will be easy because I understood a lot of web security vulnerability classes. But it wasn't. I was jumping from one program to another without much success. But fast forward to 2021, I quit my job and I finally had more time. So I wanted to challenge all these tips. And I decided that I will stick to a public bug bounty program on HackerOne and I will hunt there for 100 hours without recon, without any automations, without any of that. Just with the attitude to understand the application, just like David said in my podcast. The program I chose was Stripe. It's a payment provider that I use myself to handle payments for BBRE Premium. And I didn't believe I will find anything. I sort of wanted to prove all these tips wrong. But in 100 hours, I found 3 bugs, which gave me $3,100. I said it's an okay amount. It's slightly less than I was earning as employed pentester and much less than I'm earning as freelance pentester, which I sometimes do, but I considered it a very good start to my bug hunting journey. I described that story in Bounty Vlog number 1. If you didn't watch this video, you can check it out now using the link from the description or from the card in the top right-hand corner. For that video, I also wanted to disclose my notes from bug hunting. Everything that is not a reported bug is there. Among others, there was an unexploitable pass traversal or 2 XSSs without CSP bypasses. And before publishing those notes, I contacted Stripe just to make sure they are okay with me publishing this. They told me they won't take a detailed look at those notes, but they generally accept XSSs without CSP bypasses. Recently, they even updated their policy, saying that they do. And I think me publishing those notes impacted them because their policy also now says that you must get a written permission to publish anything you found while bug hunting. But my notes were published before that and they are still available. The link is in the description. But coming back to my 2 XSSs without CSP bypasses, I reported both of them. But for some reason, I didn't get my hopes up. I thought they will deny them because they were actually hard to exploit. They are not disclosed, so I can't tell you more about them. But I described the technique or the tool I used in one of the issues of BBRE Premium. Once these bugs get disclosed, I will point you back to where this was. That's how BBRE Premium works. For example, they recently disclosed my $1,500 SSRF. The trick that I used there, trailing.domainbypass, was published in BBRE Premium number 20. I just back then couldn't tell you that it led to an actual bug. More on that bug in another video. Coming back to my XSSs, to my surprise, both of them got triaged. So I expected $100 to $500 as a low risk issue. But they rewarded them $2,000 for each, for a total of $4,000. So I was this close to publicly disclosing $4,000 worth of bugs. What would happen is probably someone would report them instead of me. And I would look like a fool with my 3K if someone would get 4K for them. So the final result of 100 hours bug bounty challenge is $7,200. And I think it's a great result, about twice as much as I was earning when I was employed as a pentester. I also got to top 2 on Stripe's leaderboard on HackerOne. And I absolutely love this site. I made multiple screenshots just in case someone will pass me now when I'm not hacking there. I also think it's a great idea for the future to make a raid for the top one spot in one of the future bounty vlogs. The final number of hours I spent is 106. Many of you have been asking what's the tool that I use to log my time. It's called Toggle Track. I use it every time I do something related to my company. Why? Because it's useless information for me how much I earned if I don't know how much time it cost me. I recommend you to use Toggle to be better able to judge whether it's worth doing something or not. You can also log time at your job to see how much time you actually work from an 8-hour workday. I can guarantee that many of you will be surprised by how little it actually is, at least on some days. With that said, I challenge all of you to take part in BBRE 100-hour challenge. The rules are simple. Choose one bug bounty program and spend 100 hours there, no matter if you find something or not. Share your progress on Twitter and use the hashtag BBRE100Challenge so I can see that and cheer you up. If you want to download my notes from Stripe, the link is in the description. Make sure to subscribe to not miss the future video which I will make about this disclosed SSRF. But for now, thank you for watching and goodbye.